like this might overheat a Silverado or a Ram. Not this truck. Super Duty's been designed with 9 gallons of heavy-duty coolant from day one. This thing defines towing confidence.
You know, when it comes to cooling, most of us don't give it much thought. Good news for you, Ford gave it a lot of thought. This is the engine right out of our test truck. I want to show you some stuff you don't generally get to see, stuff you're really going to be grateful for when you own one of these things. This is the cylinder head, and there's some clever thinking here. They actually move water very rapidly right around the top of the combustion chamber. This draws the heat away from these valves and helps keep this head stable. To enhance that, a larger, bigger in volume, and slower in speed set of chambers to pull heat off the top of the head and circulate through the block. That's innovative thinking. Now, how are you moving that water? Well, you got a primary pump. We're talking about 9 gallons of reservoir coolant at a rate of 125 gallons per minute. We're talking huge volume here. And guess what? There's a secondary pump. You think they weren't thinking about this system? Oh, and how about this redundancy? Two thermostats, should for any reason one of these fail, the other one takes over and allows for bypass. You're not going to get deserted somewhere. Oh, and in terms of servicing, think about it. Quick disconnect hoses. How innovative is this? You don't even see this on race cars. Two C-clips and this thing's out of there. That's how you'd use your head. Chevrolet, still using a bypass hose between the bottom of the manifold and the top of the water pump. There isn't even a bypass hose on here. It's all internal. And in terms of replacing hoses, you tell me which one you'd like to take a shot at. One quick clip or this whole big monster. I got a hunch this thing ain't $4. Telling you, when it comes to cooling, and certainly on the topic of overheating, not with this truck.